Hello viewers, you welcome. Today in this video we shall learn about the story The Hundred Dresses, written by Eleanor Asset. Eleanor Asset was a librarian in a library. Once she got victim of a tuberculosis, and when she was convalescing, she started to write for time passing, and she emerged as a writer. She wrote near about 20 books, and all the books are related to children. In fact, the writer was very much successful in creating and giving a message that children, they are innocent, and the values should be taught to a person in his childhood. This story teaches us that we must not accept or reject someone on the basis of the birth of the person, or on the basis of the name of the person, or on the basis of the society status of the person. This story revolves around three children. In fact, I have encircled all the important words that I have phrases I have mentioned on the board. This story revolves around three girls, Wanda Petronsky, Peggy, and the third girl is Maddie. All the three girls were studying in the same class in a school, and Peggy and Maddie, both girls, were fast friends of each other. Wanda Petronsky, in fact, was a Polish girl whose family immigrated to America, and there they were residing at a place known as Boggins Heights. Boggins Heights was a place which was not good for sanitation. It was like a slum area where most of immigrants were living. The girl had her name Wanda Petronsky. Petronsky is a big name and a large name in comparison of American names. That's why the friend of the Wanda Petronsky girl used to make fun of her name. The girl was of very calm nature. She was always silent. She hardly talked to each other or talked to others. She could not be seen laughing ever. She just would make her face crooked and would stop before laughing. The girl used to sit in a particular place in the classroom. She used to go to school and sit in the second last row or line of room number 13. What was the reason that the girl used to sit in the last of the classroom? Because the girl would come from the place where the streets were full of mud and dust. So when she would come to school, she would come with the mud and dust caked shoes. That's why she used to sit in the last of the classroom. There, the other students who were sitting there, they got lesser score. They were not so much intelligent, and they were very noisy also, even after she used to take that seat. The friends of Wanda Petronsky asked her how many dresses she had. She would come in the classroom, in the school, in a particular uniform, clean but faded blue color dress. That's why her friends asked her the question. In reply of that question, Wanda Petronsky always said that she had 100 dresses and 60 shoes in her closet. At the reply, or after having the reply, the girls would laugh behind Wanda Petronsky. They would not laugh in front of her. Now we shall see that the other girls, Peggy and Maddie, why did they make fun of Wanda Petronsky, and what kind of girls were they? In fact, Peggy was a generous, pretty, beautiful girl with the curly hair, but the girl, she used to make fun of Wanda Petronsky because of the one reason. The reason was very simple. Whenever these girls, Peggy and Maddie,
asked Wanda Petrowski how many dresses she had. She would reply about 100 dresses and 60 shoes. At that point, they would make fun of her. In fact, before coming to school and at the time of departure, the girls used to follow Wanda Petrowski to make fun of her. But Peggy was not a bad girl at all. She was against any sort of violence. She would cry bitterly if she came to know that someone harmed animals. Moreover, she was against bullying others. Bullying means to torture someone who is weaker than you mentally or emotionally. Peggy was a fast friend of Maddie. Peggy was so much generous that she used to help Maddie at every point. Maddie would wear the old clothes of Peggy. Maddie was also a true friend. She wanted to protest Peggy for making fun of Wanda Petrowski, but she never dared so, because she would think Peggy could not be wrong at any point. And once she wrote down a note in her diary to give it to Peggy, but she tore it into pieces because she could not dare to ask her to stop making fun of Wanda Petrowski. In the end of the story, part 1, we see that there was a competition contest in the school, and Miss Mason asked the children to prepare dress designs. It was the topic for the girls. The boys were given the topic of preparing motor boats, and the girls were given the topic of designing dress designs. And on Wednesday, on the day of contest, when these two girls, Peggy and Maddie, reached in the classroom, they saw various designs in the classroom displayed. When they saw it, their eyes kept opened. They were amazed and shocked, and they did not take any time to realize that all these under designs are prepared by Wanda Petrowski. But the fact was there. Wanda Petrowski has left the school. She was not present in the school, but she sent her designs of dresses to Miss Mason. And at the end of the competition, Miss Mason announced the result that the winner in the girls category is Wanda Petrowski, and in the category of the boys, Jack is the winner. So this is the end of part 1 of the 100 dresses. Now let us discuss about the question answers of this chapter. What kind of girl was Wanda Petrowski? So Wanda Petrowski was a Polish girl. She belonged to an immigrant family in America, and she lived at Bogen Heights, which was not a very fine area to live. She was very calm and she never laughed. The girl was very sensitive. She used to sit at a particular place because she did not want to reveal her bad conditions that used to come with her through her shoes. Then the girl was a very genius also. She had prepared very beautiful designs of the dresses. In totality, Wanda Petrowski was a very good girl. Now let us move to Peggy. Peggy, what kind of girl was Peggy, or develop the character sketch of a Peggy? Peggy was also a generous, pretty girl with beautiful curly hair, but that girl used to make fun of Wanda Petrowski. On the other hand, she was against violence. She was against bullying others. She would protect all the girls from being bullied. Moreover, she was a helpful girl also. She was a very helping girl. She used to help Maddie at every point in her schooling life.